They're catching fish.
That's awesome.
Assalamualaikum and welcome to another episode of the Paddy Field Fishing Vlogging in a Windy Environment episode. And again, the solution. In this canal thingy is where we usually like to go fishing, and my wife is over there. You can see. See? That's my wife! Today, I just finished writing an article about emotional maturity for Majalah Iman. And if you don't know, Majalah Iman is a Malay magazine here in Malaysia, and I am one of its columnists. And I just wrote a new article today, but it will be printed out in December. So I'm giving you a sneak preview here in this vlog. So this is exclusive, right? So don't tell anybody. Especially the publisher of the magazine, because I don't know, they might not like it. One of the inspirations for that article is my son Rayyan, who is now 1 year and 3 months old, maybe. The basic premise of the whole article is that if we want to be emotionally mature, we have to look at children, and we have to observe how they express their emotions. And we just have to do the opposite of that. So they are giving us examples of what not to do. Assalamualaikum. Awkward. A child expresses emotions without any filtering. A child just do whatever that he feels like doing. So in a child's mind, the basic equation is very, very simple. Whatever I like, I want. Whatever I don't like, I don't want. It's not that a child is evil in that sense. No, that's normal for a child. A child is very egocentric. A child has a massive, massive ego, and a child only thinks about what feels good for himself. So whatever that he does, his main goal is to make sure that he feels good, he feels satisfied, he gets what he wants. As adults, we learn that making ourselves feel better is not enough. What's more important is to make the situation better. So as adults, our focus have shifted from ourselves to others. So we're focusing more on the greater good. At least in theory, that's what adults should be lah. It is dark. Let's light this up. Yeah. Based on experience, we know that even adults, some adults, they don't act. They don't express their emotions in a way that they should. They're thinking about what's good for themselves. So the focus is that as long as I feel good, then job done. Let me give you an example. Let's say somebody posted something on the internet that you don't like, which happens almost every day. You would think about, okay, all right. So my wife is showing off. She caught a fish. Okay, congratulations. Oh, no. Okay. I got it. What was I talking about? Emotional maturity? Yeah. Okay, so somebody posted something you don't like on the internet. So the question now is, how would you express that emotion? How would you express that dislike? If you are a child, you will just go with the flow and express in whatever way that will make you feel better. So you just vent. But since you are an adult, you would filter that emotion, you would calculate the context, see the situation in a bigger picture, and then think about what will be a better expression of this emotion such that the situation will become better and my action will be more productive. So instead of responding to that post in a negative, emotional, childish kind of way, like a child would, you would think more long term about what would be better for everybody, almost everybody in that situation. So instead of commenting, "You suck," you would actually have arguments, like mature adult arguments, to counter whatever that you disagree with, if you think that that would make the situation better. Now, I know that sounds like a lot of work because it's easier to simply respond just like that, but that's what adulthood is all about. You think more. You consider things more. A child doesn't have that ability. A child doesn't have that level of consideration. A child simply acts. A child is reactive. Whereas adults, we are reflective.
At least we should be.
That is what a child needs to learn, and we are their teachers. But in order for us to teach them that, we first have to overcome our own emotional immaturity, which was built in at the time when we were a little boy or girl. So that is my message for today. If you want to read up on the full version of that message, just buy a copy of Majalah Iman in December and look for my name. Thank you for watching. If you like it, click like. And if you want to share it, click share. If you want to subscribe, click subscribe. Until next time, I'll see you. Assalamualaikum. Bye-bye.